TEEB stands for The Economics of Ecosystems and Biodiversity. Perhaps we should have called it The Economics of Nature, because that's what it's about. And the challenge here is that nature provides a lot to us every day in terms of food, fuel, fiber, but also ecosystem services like flood prevention and drought control, which forests provide, or pollination, which bees provide for agriculture. But most of these services that nature provides are for free. They are public services. We don't measure their value. The net result is we ignore them. You cannot manage what you do not measure. Well, TEEB is really a structured approach towards explaining to countries, to local governments, and to businesses how you can understand the value of the ecosystem services that are received by them and important for them. So we provide the framework, we provide the methodologies, and then we help governments through the so-called country TEEB studies that are going on these days, almost 25 of them, and we help companies by encouraging them to look at our methodologies and to use them to assess the value that nature provides to the business and the impacts that business has on nature, which can be negative. If we look at land today, that is agriculture, and look at productivity, two things are very important. One is to understand that more than half, almost 60% of the land on Earth is actually tilled in small farms. It's not massive industrial complexes. And this is important in two ways. One, because we have here the livelihoods of more than 1 billion farmers in the developing world. And if we can only figure out some way of improving the productivity of their land, improving the output that they get per hectare, that would be a huge solution to two big problems. One is poverty, because they would get more income, and the other is hunger, because there would be more food going around. We are talking about huge increases possible on small farms around the world using ecologically friendly farming methods. The studies done by Jules Pretty and by the FAO demonstrate that there can be increases of in one of these studies 79%, in another of these studies 180%, if we only apply ecologically friendly approaches to these farms. As these studies come to fruition, what we will find is that they are providing the countries who are engaging them the infrastructure, the toolkit, if you like, to value ecosystem services and their benefits for policy areas as significant as animal husbandry and agriculture and the reduction of rural poverty and the prevention of desertification and the assurance of fresh water supply. All of these are important policy areas in most developing countries. There was a study done recently by TrueCost, a research firm in London, which estimated that the total environmental externalities, in other words, the costs to the environment and to society of doing business as usual, was something like $2.1 trillion, $2.1 million, 3.5% of global GDP, from the top 3,000 companies. Now, what they're clearly doing is creating third-party costs, in other words, creating social costs whilst making private profits. That's a free lunch. That can't go on. If you look at ecosystem services, sometimes people say, well, yes, of course they're valuable, but you know, they are 5%, 10%, 15% of GDP, and indeed, if you wish to measure them that way, that's what they will be. However, that's not really the right question. The real question to ask is, what are ecosystem services as a fraction of the household incomes of the rural poor? And that answer, when we did this calculation in one of the TEEB studies, that answer in the case of India was 47% on average, that's for 350 million people who depend on these services. In Indonesia, for almost 100 million people, that answer was close to 75%. In Brazil, for 20 million people who depend on the gathering of nuts and fruit and so on in the northern Amazon, that answer was 89% on average. Now, that's the whole point. You have to think of ecosystem services consumed by the poor as a fraction of the GDP of the poor. Then you realize how important they are. An example of steps in the right direction have been taken already by Paul Pullman's initiative, which is called the Tropical Forest Alliance. It's actually an initiative begun by the Consumer Association in the US and supported by Paul Pullman, the chairman of Unilever, and supported by the president of Indonesia, Mr. Yudhoyono. Their first meeting was in June in 2013, where they pulled together four major agricultural and forestry industries which had huge impacts on rainforests, these being beef and soya, and pulp and paper, and palm oil. And the objective of this Tropical Forest Alliance is to ensure that these four major contributors to deforestation in the tropics can actually bring down that deforestation to zero by 2020. That's the right model. It's got to be a sectoral cooperative model supported by the relevant governments.